the speaker and members of this debate. In the Philippines, education has become a key factor, Madam Speaker, in determining one's social and economic mobility, you know, to be able to climb one step higher in the ladder of social strata. And this has been, Madam Speaker, a collective interest, a collective goal. We need to clarify two things in this debate. First, is privatization necessary in this particular context, because that is basically what the motion calls for. Say to that, our answer to that is yes. Second, Madam Speaker, does the state really need resources under our model? The answer to that is no. Okay, let's talk about the first issue, Madam Speaker. Is priority necessary? Yes, there was no adequate response from the POI, Madam Speaker, that you know Philippine education has regarded to one of problems in the status quo. We point you to the teacher-student ratio, we point you to, you know, these lower levels, the primary and secondary, the problems in that particular instance, Madam Speaker. Not only do we have national deficit as a whole, we don't think, Madam Speaker, that our budget at present in terms of education is actually more than enough. Not only because of financial constraints, Madam Speaker, we tell you that prioritization is actually necessary in the status quo because we need to take advantage over the present existing economic order, Madam Speaker. And talking about globalization of that, Madam Speaker, and numerous of this house, we tell you that we need to maximize available resources. And in this particular instance, the resource that we have, the very potent resource that we have, is human resources. Ladies and gentlemen, members of this debate, Filipinos are known globally as competent nurses, as competent seamen at that, as competent computer technicians at that, Madam Speaker, and members of this house. And we don't think that there is a valid clash in this debate. Because, Mr. Speaker, the social clamor, Mr. Speaker, that they fabricate about, you know, people who really wants to go to this, who really wants to choose, can no longer choose, because they actually assume in this debate, which is quite simplistic, is the assumption that, you know, the choice of future career is highly dependent upon government subsidy. We don't think that is in the case in this debate, Mr. Speaker, and members of this house, because the courses that they are talking about, you know, mass com, liberal arts, and things like that, Mr. Speaker, is that, you know, that people can actually afford to get into this particular, courses, Mr. Speaker, and members of this house, and we don't think that there is a dire necessity, Mr. Speaker, to actually equalize this, because in status quo, social clamor when it comes to the demand of these particular courses are not really as bad as they actually characterized in this debate, Mr. Speaker. Now to the second very important clarification that this debate must answer and this debate must dwell in. The state really limits choices under our model, Mr. Speaker, and members of this house. We tell you that subsidy is necessary in this particular instance, that prioritization is necessary in this particular instance. It does not limit choices. Now, let me ask you a very simplistic question as well, Mr. Speaker. Does this limit choices or does this extend choices to the people who never had a choice to begin with? That is the very nature of this debate. That is what this debate calls for. How do you maximize available resources? How do you make an unproductive population self-reliant eventually, Mr. Speaker? You know, eventually be self-reliant and have the means to pursue whatever you want in life. I'm going to talk about three issues in this debate. First is how they balance individual versus collective interests, Mr. Speaker. Second, we're going to talk about government responsibility. In this context. Now, individual versus collective interest. I want to be a teacher, but it's not being subsidized by government. Okay, this is what you should do. At present, you need to enroll in particular subjects that are being subsidized, Mr. Speaker. So eventually you can take that particular course that you want. We tell you that prioritization is necessary because, Mr. Speaker, we need again and again, we like to point out that it is economically advantageous to our country because we need to take advantage of the present economic order, which is globalization, Mr. Speaker, and members of this debate. Without remittance of OFWs, Mr. Speaker, this economy is now dead, Mr. Speaker, and members of this house. We don't think, Mr. Speaker, that, you know, may want to become somebody at the end of the day, tramples national welfare at the end of the day. Now let's talk about government responsibility in this debate. And why, Mr. Speaker, this is also a necessary area this debate must talk about, since primarily we're talking about government action in this particular instance. Salus populis supremum. numbers of transitions down the view.
Okay.
This is a very crucial situation. This is a very crucial time of speaker. Crucial time of speaker, and we tell you that government needs to prioritize the speaker. Why? Because this gives a chance for people in the speaker an opportunity to actually climb higher in the social strata of the speaker members of this house, for people not to remain stagnant. Yeah? I'm talking about people who never really have the choice to be with the speaker. That is what this today is talking about, and not people in the speaker who actually have choices, but you know, they can't have the choices because of some financial reasons.
Courses which are useless for you and deserves no prioritization, at least three.
Then there's a video about globalization that a present to the speaker, there are particular courses to the speaker that actually is complementary to that of globalization.
Of course.
That's, okay, nursing to the speaker. Nursing to the speaker, that is in demand today when the speaker members of the South. Information technology is one course to the speaker that actually is not only exclusive, its functions is not only exclusive within national level, but also
because all 7 minutes and 4 seconds.
Thank you, Governor.